Your Excellencies, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, because I have been asked by, actually instructed, I think, by President Sassou Nguesso to give a progress report on the meeting we had in Paris on the financing pact. And you know, in keeping with African tradition, when an elder gives instructions, you have to obey. So let me give a brief progress report, and I hope he will be listening. After the meetings we had in Paris, we subsequently had the Africa Climate Summit, in which we consolidated our position as a continent. And we were clear on what kind of financing infrastructure that we were looking for. Number one, we were looking for concessionary resources that would make sense to our development. Number two, we were looking for long-term resources that had grace periods of up to 10 years and repayment periods of up to 40 years. Number three, we wanted these resources at scale. And number four, we were very clear that these resources were meant for the financing of our development. We subsequently took our position to COP28, and we had a very positive conversation. And finally, we launched the Africa Green Industrialization Initiative that will provide a mechanism for investment in our green energy resources to facilitate industrialization, to create jobs, to create wealth, and to move Africa to the next level. Subsequently, we came here a month ago. And by the time we were in COP28, the difficulties we had in Paris of whether we need reform of the international financial architecture, you remember the heated conversation we had in Paris, because many countries in Paris did not believe that there was a requirement or there was need of whatever nature for the transformation and reform of the international financial architecture. But by the time we were getting in December, in COP28, there was concurrence in Europe, in America, in Asia, and of course in Africa, that there was need. And everybody agreed that there was need to reform these financial institutions. Fast forward, last month, we had a meeting here with the World Bank to discuss concessionary resources in the IDA window replenishment 21. We made very good progress with the World Bank in that framework. Step forward, last week, the outcome of my visit to the United States, there were two significant outcomes. Outcome number one is investment of $1 billion for the first data center powered by green energy in Kenya. And number two, after extensive consultations with President Biden, and because he confirmed to me that he believed in the transformation of Africa and he wanted to support, because of the conversations we had, you remember, at the Africa Leaders Summit in America last year. And because America is a big contributor both to IDA and to Africa Development Fund, President Biden committed $21 billion that will go to some of it to the two institutions, World Bank IDA framework and Africa Development Bank's Africa Development Fund program, which we are discussing here today. The replenishment, the $25 billion Adesina is looking for the Africa Development Fund. And today, Mr. President, we are furthering that conversation with the confirmations we're going to make to enhance significant funding, concessional resources to Africa Development Fund so that we can meet the targets where we wanted concessional funding, long-term resources, and at scale. I hope I have made a good case and I have met the pass mark. Your Excellencies, I acknowledge the insightful remarks you have made on Africa's prospects. Your words underline the critical need to match our continent's immense potential with corresponding concessional financing and action. I reiterate that there is a clear necessity for increased funding in the next replenishment cycle of Africa Development Fund with a target of not less than $25 billion. Looking ahead, the Africa Development Bank will be central in addressing Africa's challenges by financing climate change mitigation, adaptation, green industrialization, and closing the infrastructure gap in rail, in road networks, internet broadband, energy, and the development of our ports. As we celebrate the Africa Development Bank's 60th anniversary here in Nairobi, it is vital for us as African leaders to support the bank's transformative role by supporting its access to concessional resources for our continent's transformation. Additionally, it is time, as I said, to support an African-created rating agency that will provide accurate and fair assessment of Africa's economic realities and status. It is said in our country that poverty cannot be shared. What can be shared is wealth and prosperity. And so, Kenya can only be prosperous in a thriving continental neighborhood. That is why last week, as an engaged American government, 60% of the time I spent prosecuting Africa's agenda, and 40% of the time I spent pushing Kenya's agenda, because I understand that there cannot be a prosperous Kenya without a thriving Africa. And therefore, I want to state without fear of any contradiction that the progress and transformation of Kenya is intertwined with that of Africa. Kenya is honored to host this meeting, and we take the boards and management of the two institutions, we thank them for this privilege. I have already requested that after hosting Africa Development Bank's annual meeting 30 years ago in 1994, and again today in 2024, it would be fair and fitting for Kenya to host again in 2054. I am told by my brother Evangelist Adesina that my request is under consideration. I would request that this decision be made early, because neither we nor the decision makers then might be fit enough to do so 30 years from now. Once again, I welcome you all to Nairobi and Kenya and wish you fruitful deliberations during this annual meeting of the African Development Bank and African Development Fund. I urge you to take time to sample the delights that Kenya has to offer, including a national park which is just 10 minutes away from here. Thank you very much. Happy 60th anniversary, Africa Development Bank. Thank you.